North America, Climate, Vegetation and Wildlife, Part 1. North America lies entirely in the northern hemisphere, and the width of the continent is maximum in the middle latitudes, and so most of the continent lies in the temperate zone. A small part of North America lies south of the Tropic of Cancer. Southern Mexico, the countries of Central America and the Caribbean islands have a subtropical climate. The Arctic Circle passes through the extreme north, a region which is extremely cold. The large size of the continent results in great extremes of temperatures in most parts of the continent. Thus, the summers are hot and winters are cold. The western cordilleras, as well as the eastern highlands, run parallel to the coast. They cut off the influence of the ocean from reaching the interior to a good extent. The cold Labrador Current in the northeast keeps the adjoining coast frozen in winter. The cool California Current in the southwest lowers the temperatures along the coast. Winds blowing over this current get cooled and pick up little moisture and bring little rainfall. The warm Alaska Current in the northwest warms the adjoining coastal regions. Winds blowing over these currents are also warm, and so their ability to absorb moisture increases. These winds bring heavy rainfall throughout the year. The Great Lakes are like the ocean. French missionaries, gazing across a seemingly limitless horizon of water in the 17th century, thought they had found the ocean. They called them sweet water seas. The lake waters provide inexpensive transportation. Large seafaring ships can reach the interior since the lakes are connected to the Atlantic Ocean by the St. Lawrence Waterway. The first such climatic region is the tundra region. The extreme northern part of North America that lies beyond the Arctic Circle has very cold climatic conditions. It includes the northern coast of Canada and the northern